You can crack jokes if you want to, but these things do have a habit of going off, you know. Put it away. We don't get much of a chance to chat, do we? When I first came in here, you wouldn't leave me alone. So now I'm telling you, stay out of my business. And tell your friends, if anyone interferes, they're dead.
Aren't you going to introduce me to your friend?
Pamela Madigan, Rodney Adams. We have to work with each other.
There, that wasn't so bad, was it?
I don't know what you're talking about.
Good.
I'm going to go find a table. It's been a pleasure meeting you.
Oh, Miss Madigan, I'm sorry.
Oh, call me Pam. Don't worry about it. Be thankful you're not like him.
I want you and Kath to shake hands. Hey? So that everyone can see how easy it is.
Yeah, go on. Just what good mates you can be.
And I'm going to put on a magic show tonight and because Lisa's got me new tricks. Kath, come on. Reed, come on, Reed. Come on.
Look, we go back a long way, but...
Please, it's just for the night.
You're all over the news, except they're calling you Lorelei now.
Len, I'm in trouble.
Sorry, honey.
Len.
Are you going to keep that up all night?
What? That mumbling.
I can't help it, Kath. I'm just real happy we're back together again, aren't you, Kath? Just a little bit.
Of course I am. It wasn't my idea to go away. I told you that.
Yeah, I'm just real happy we're back. Hey, would you read me a comic before bed?
Oh, I might.
Rita and Alice read to me while you were gone. If they weren't as good as you. I'm real happy that everyone springs after me party, aren't you, Kath?
Yes.
Hey. Captain Marvelous and the Attack of the Toad People. Would you read me that one?
Now, look, if you don't get ready for bed, there won't be any time to read anything.
All right, ready in a sec.
I'm glad you made so many friends while I was away, Merle. I was a bit worried you might be lonely.
Yeah.
What about the two new women? Did you make friends with them?
You mean Lisa and Wendy?
Yeah.
Lisa showed me my first magic trick.
Did she?
Yeah.
And what about Wendy?
No, I don't think she knows any.
Any what?
Magic tricks.
Oh. And does Wendy get along with the other women okay?
Suppose. Mrs. Morris doesn't like her very much. She keeps sending her to Mrs. Reynolds' office.
Come on, lock up. Get a move on.
Well, I was just catching up on a bit of gossip. I've been away for a while, you know.
Yes, well, now that you're back, just remember who gives the orders.
How could I forget?
Quick, Wend, get a towel for me.
Thanks. You looked all right as a blonde. I don't know why you bother.
Because I'm bored out of me brain. It's bad enough being locked away from your man. I've not been able to get a message to him.
Well, you could always try again. It was just bad luck Pete was caught by the cops.
Oh, bad luck, nothing. Typical bloody man has to hoon around.
Maybe you should have got one of your girlfriends instead.
Yeah. You know what? I need someone like Spider Simpson on the outside.
Why is that?
She had no trouble getting a message to us when Pete screwed up. Maybe I could,
What?
Get her to contact Lester for me.
Probably could if you had the money to pay her.
I'll get the money when I contact him.
I think that's what they call catch 22.
Well, look, it can't be that hard to get something out. It seems to me there's people coming in here, going out of here all the time.
Yeah. Maybe that's something you should be keeping an eye on.
What?
Well, new arrivals, you know. Just in case.
In case what?
Well, just in case the cops were being straight with you and one of your marks was Mr. Big, alias Thomas Gilmore.
So what?
Well, he'd be out to get rid of you.
And Lester.
You know too much, and you've got photographs to boot. Maybe that's why Lester hasn't been in touch. Maybe Gilmore's caught up with him already.
Oh, come on, Wynn, that's just bull. Cops are just trying to scare me.
As long as you're sure.
Well, how could they get to me in here?
As you say, people coming and going all the time. I wouldn't be too trusting of anyone if I was you. Particularly types like Kath Maxwell start turning up.
Maxwell?
I'm not saying it means anything. A bit sus, that story about her being kidnapped. What if someone wanted to brief her for a job? And she deliberately let the cops catch her and bring her back here?
Come on, she's not a killer.
Why do you think she's in here? You're probably right. I'd be a bit more careful if I was you. Evening.
Take your time, ladies. You've got 10 seconds.
Has she been in touch with you, Ferguson?
I beg your pardon?
Oh, cut the crap. She's out there with a little kid, so she's desperate. And you want to know something crazy? She liked you, Miss Ferguson. So have you heard from her or not?
If you're talking about Wilkinson, I don't help criminals.
Jeez, what a bitch. Maybe Laurie will be all right. Well, she's got lots of friends.
What friends?
All those blokes used to call her uncle.
Oh, that bloody chance.
They'll read the papers, know the cops are after her, run a mile if she goes anywhere near them.
Jeez, what can we do?
Nothing! Because we don't know where she is and we've got no way of finding out.
We've got to do something.
Like what? And as if I haven't got enough on me plate with Maxwell.
Oh, she's all bluff. Look, if she uses that gun, she'll be mincemeat in seconds and she knows it.
The person she uses it on won't be too wealthy either. I don't really fancy trying to find out. It's got to be some other way.
Hey, well, maybe the screws will catch her with it.
Sure solve the problem if they did. Yeah, for something like that, they might find room for her in Blackmore, full up or not. She'd be out of our hair good and proper then, wouldn't she?
Wentworth Detention Centre? Oh, yes, Sergeant. Oh, yes, she is. Just a moment. It's a Sergeant Groves. Wants to speak to you.
Ferguson? Oh, yes, yes, one of your people rang me this morning. And I told him all I knew. But you must have the names of all her known associates. Have you tried them all? Yes, yes, well, I'm sorry. There's no more I can tell you. I certainly will if I hear from her. Yes. Bye.
Good. Why would the police contact you? Is everything all right?
Yes. Good night.
Good night?
And I said, no good asking me. I'm just a visitor here. That was funny, Anne.
Oh, sorry, I wasn't really listening.
Oh, that's okay. To tell the truth, it wasn't really funny. You look like something's bothering you.
Not something, someone.
Ah, your little friend Rodney.
God forbid anyone should think he's a friend. Who the hell does he think he is treating you like that?
You take things too much to heart, Anne. You've been my friend a long time. You've seen his sort before. You should be used to it by now.
Not the sort of thing I'll ever get used to.
Oh, come on. You think the Rodneys of this world are worth wasting energy on? It's the serious racists. The ones with intelligence to know what they're talking about. They're the dangerous ones.
Mm.
Oh, lighten up. We'll get there. You can't change the world in a couple of centuries, you know. Ah, that'll be him. Come to apologise.
Oh.
Miss Ferguson.
I was on my way home. I wondered if I could talk with you for a minute.
Come in.
Thank you.
Hello. Coffee?
No, thank you. I won't stay. I wondered if...
Oh, if you two want some privacy, I'll go and check out the view from the balcony or something.
I don't think so. If it's as confidential as that, it probably should wait until work tomorrow.
It's about Wilkinson.
Oh, have the police caught her?
No. I had a call from them just before I left the prison. They've checked all her known associates, but there's no sign of her.
And?
Well, I wondered if you, as governor, might not have some information that we're not aware of.
I'm sorry, I don't know any more than you do. Maybe less.
Well, I haven't the slightest idea. It's just that she's got the little girl with her. God knows what risks she's already exposed her to. I want to see her caught before anything serious happens.
Thank you.
You obviously agree with the court that the girl's an unfit mother?
No, not really. What she did was pretty stupid, but it was only because she loves the child. I think if the court had granted custody, she'd have been a good mother.
Maybe you should have said so in court.
I didn't get the chance.
What sort of counselling did she have?
She had an excellent solicitor.
Not legal, I meant a sociologist.
I would have thought the most important thing was good legal advice.
Maybe, but the decision still went against her.
Do you think you could have done more?
Oh, we'll never know, will we?
You social workers really get to me.
What's that mean?
It means that if you and your do-good cronies were doing your job properly, the crime rate wouldn't be quite so high, particularly among your own people.
I think it's time we changed the subject.
Like hell. She wants to talk facts and figures. She wants to talk about the black crime rate. Why don't you check your precious facts and figures and see the kind of so-called crime most of those blacks are locked up for?
Oh, I don't have to. Drunken disorderly, assault, breaking...
Let me tell you a story. Journalist went to do a feature story on a black settlement, a mission. Trouble was he couldn't find anything to write about. They were all ordinary, boring people who just happened to be black. So he went away and came back that night with a truckload of grog, ended up a full-scale riot with half the population in jail, and he got a great story.
No one forced them to drink the stuff.
That's right. And if they were silly enough to fall for an obvious con like that, maybe they deserve what they got. My point is, that journalist knew exactly what he was doing. He should have been strung out by the thumbs. Instead, he got an upgrading. You tell me where the justice is in that.
Sure, there are two sides to the story. I didn't come here to argue politics. If Wilkinson should get in touch with you, would you be kind enough to let me know?
It's hardly likely. See what happens. Sorry. You had every right to be angry.
Don't you see? If we're going to get anywhere, we need honesty on both sides. Want to hear a joke? What's black and white, black and white, black and white?
I don't know.
A bong fighting a seagull for a chip. What's black and tan and looks good on a bong? A Doberman. Two bongs fall over a cliff. One that weighs 60 kilos, the other 100. Who hits the ground first? Who cares? You're not laughing, Anne.
Of course not. Those jokes are sick.
Yes. And the sickest thing of all is that they all have an element of truth. There are blacks scrounging in the gutters for scraps. And there are people who'd love to set their dogs on us. And there's sure as hell plenty of people who couldn't give a stuff if every one of us fell over a cliff. If the day ever comes when you and I can laugh about jokes like that, knowing there's no truth in them, then we know we've made it. But that day is a long way off and coming. And there's still a lot of prejudice to be broken down.
I know. I'm just glad I don't have to do it. I don't envy you your job.
I look on the bright side. At least I don't have to work with Joan Ferguson.
Well, if you want to put it that way. What a swap.
Cheers.
Cheers.
I'm so sorry, Princess. I know that this is an awful thing to put a little girl through. At least we're together. And it won't be for long. We'll find somewhere.
I was hoping we'd hear some word of Wilkinson and her daughter during the night, but it's been nothing.
Oh, it's an awful thing to say, but I almost hope she gets away with it.
Yes, I know what you mean, but the little girl I'm worried about.
Good morning.
Oh, good morning. Anything wrong?
No. Oh, I met Mrs. Reynolds' friend Pamela Madigan last night. She's a lovely lady.
Oh, yes, excellent reputation. People speak very highly of her and her work.
Well, Mrs. Reynolds obviously thinks a lot of her. They seem quite close.
Yes, well, frankly, I would have thought Mrs. Reynolds had more taste. But on second thoughts, maybe it's not so surprising.
What's got into you?
Oh, a bit of good old-fashioned racism, that's what.
Oh, well, why not? I mean, I've had to work for everything I've got. They just cry persecution and we hand it all to them on a plate. My taxes pay for it.
Oh, Rodney, that's a bit strong.
Look, if they want it, let them earn it. Most of them are too drunk to care anyway.
Oh, what a dreadful thing to say.
That'd be about all I'd expect from you.
Oh, that's enough. And here you're through the building. If you two want to argue, do it in your own time. When stout, you're supposed to be on muster.
Yes, miss, on my way.
Wasn't Delia's fault. She was provoked.
I thought you were off duty.
Oh, yes, yes, I'm on my way.
Just a minute.
What?
A word with you. time we had a talk about Maxwell and you.
I have to get to work.
All right, you do that and I'll tell the governor how you helped her escape.
You what?
Don't act the innocent. I know a lot more than you think. Like the call to the police, I just saw her out of Red Hill. It's that I'm anti-euthanasia.
I don't know what you're talking about.
Don't you? Well, let's go and see the governor then.
Look, I had nothing to do with Maxwell's escape and you can't prove that I did.
You and Maxwell have been working together, and a lot more. So, are you going to tell me what I want to know? Because maybe, just maybe, you'll have a job tomorrow.
All right, Ivan. Just go to work.
No, I'm not leaving you here all upset like this.
We'd hear something. I'm so frightened that something's happened to Zoe.
Look, it won't have. The police will find them soon. This could be some news now.
I'll get it.
Well, how's things?
Hi, Elise. Lunch time yet? I'm starving.
I'll be a few minutes. Thought I'd just come and say hello, we're waiting.
Oh, right.
How's Kath? Settling back in?
Yeah. Hey, can you show me another trick?
Not now, maybe later. Must have given her an awful fright being taken away from prison like that.
Who?
Kath.
Yeah, I suppose.
That's what happened, isn't it? She was kidnapped, like in your comics.
No, I don't think so.
That's what she said, isn't it?
Well, I don't know, but I'm going to get the ones that took her away. I don't know, but Kath knows. Oh, last night, she was asking a lot of questions about you, and I said that you showed me a lot of magic tricks. Come on, let's go and wait for lunch. I love being up the front of the line.
Please don't.
I'm calling the police.
I want to talk to you first.
Call them, Ivan.
I didn't come here to make trouble. I came here to explain.
Explain? Explain stealing our baby. And explain this.
How can I steal my own baby?
She's not yours. You forfeited her the moment you turned to crime.
And the court gave her to us.
I didn't come here to fight with you. I came to talk to you. You see, last night I realized that it's not fair to Zoe. I love her, and I want her with me, and I need her. But it just isn't fair.
You should have thought of that sooner.
I took her because I love her and I need her. Can't you understand that?
Don't you think we love her too?
Not the way I do. You can't.
You've got a funny way of showing it.
And you just don't want to believe it, Mr. Hosking.
Why should we? It was so easy for you, wasn't it? She was probably an accident anyway. I bet you tried to get rid of her.
You don't know what you're talking about.
Miss Wilkinson. My wife and I can't have children. And when we see other people taking it for granted...
I did not take it for granted, Mr. Hosking. I love my little daughter more than you can imagine. And I would give anything in this world to keep her. But you see, the one thing I can't give her is a nice home and a decent chance in life. And you and your wife can't give her that. I'm going to leave Zoe here with you, and I'm going to give myself up to the police. It's just a favor I'd like to ask you. Could I have a few hours with her? Here, where she feels safe?
I don't know.
Mrs. Hosking, I'm going back inside for a long time. You've got the rest of your life with my daughter. Now, is it too much to ask for me to spend some time to say goodbye to her?
You're out
out of your mind?
Look, I'm not arguing. Those are the terms.
Well, it won't work. There's no way the women will accept another 50% off the top.
Okay, forget it.
Wait a minute. You're smart enough to know I can't afford it. Why ask?
Because you're smart enough to lift your profits if it's the only way for you to get back in business. And it is.
Someone's putting the squeeze on you. Who is it?
No one. It's a simple enough deal. I'll keep running the phone bets for you and I'll sneak back the casino equipment. But I want that extra 50%.
Is it Joan Ferguson?
I told you it's no one.
Listen, Rodney. Whoever it is, we can cut them out. All it needs is for us to work together like before.
I told you the terms. Are you agreeing or do I find somebody else to deal with?
Listen.
Heard you're looking for me.
Yeah. You know that message you got in? Well, I was wondering if you could get one out as well.
Sure. Cost you that.
I'll pay. This is to me boyfriend telling him to send in money.
Oh, I deal strictly cash. How do I know he hasn't got another chick in your scraps?
Look, he'll come through, I swear. I'll pay you whatever you reckon it's worth as soon as I get the money in.
Yeah, all right, I'll take a chance. But if you're wrong, I collect in skin and teeth.
Nah, it'd be all right, honest. Look, give this to Pete and he'll give it to me boyfriend.
Yeah.
Thanks, you're a lifesaver. Baby, come through for me. This is real urgent. Those necks of John Smith, he's really Thomas Gilmore, the guy who runs the mob. He's out to kill me, and you too. Our only chance is if I find out where to meet him to collect our payoffs. Then I can do a deal with the cops and maybe get out of here. I won't tell him anything about you. So once they get Gilmore off our backs, we can still keep squeezing all the other suckers. But hurry, please. Love, Lise.
Wentworth Detention Centre, Officer Ferguson speaking. Wentworth Detention Centre, can I help you?
It's me, Lorelei.
Where the hell are you?
I'm at the Hoskings.
Oh, you've gotten yourself into a real mess this time. But don't think you're going to involve me.
No, Joan, I'm giving myself up.
Miss Ferguson, do you?
I'm going to the police, and I'd really like it if you'd come here.
What?
I think it's better if you're with me, and then we can go to Sergeant Watson and explain.
Explain? Explain an armed robbery? God, you're demented. Have you seen the papers?
Yes.
Armed robbery is not some stupid con. Oh, you've gone up in the world now. You are in deep.
That's why I want you to come to the police with me.
After the runaround you've given me, no way.
Joan, I'm giving up. Zoe, I need you.
No. Wait.
Is she coming?
Yeah. Well, she'll take a while. She can't just walk out, but of course she'll come. Won't she, darling? Hey? You see, Mummy's got to go away. She's going to go to a place just like this. A beautiful castle high up in the hill. And there'll be about 12 windows where I can see all the world. And I'll always know how you are and where you are. Because I love you, darling. I know you want to go there. But you'll come there one time. One time you'll come there. Because I love you, darling.
Where goes Mummy?
Hey, that's great.
It's nothing. Just wait till I pull those contact papers out of nowhere.
Yeah? How do you plan to do that?
I've already done it.
What?
Well, practically. Gave Spider a letter to give to Lester via Pete.
Yeah? What was in it? Oh, shouldn't I ask?
I hid. I'll go crazy if I don't talk to someone.
Yeah, me too. All right, go on.
Well, I've told him who our John Smith really is. Just wait till he finds out we've tapped Mr. Big.
Then what?
Well, Gilmore went to a lot of trouble to play dead. Now Lester and me both know he's alive.
So I want you both out of the way, just like the cops
yeah,
said?
Yeah, they're on the level for once. There's only one way for Lester and me. Gilmore's got to go up. When Lester finds out, he'll give me the contact and we'll be home and hosed.
Ooh, nice.
Isn't it? And that's where we come to our happy ending. So what do you suppose the boys from the dope squad are going to say when I wave those contacts in front of them?
So they jump at them.
Like trouts. We'll do a little deal. As they say in the business, kazam. I'll be on the outside, Lester may be back in business, and Gilmore will be in the slammer wondering why the roof fell in.
And he'll never know it was you.
It's all sleight of hand.
You're telling me that some bitch sold this out of Wentworth to a filthy junkie who cashed it in for a hit before you even saw it?
Mr. Gilmore, I'm sorry.
How many others have read it?
I don't know.
Why do you think I keep paying through the nose to scum like this, hey? Why?
So you wouldn't blow your cover, so they wouldn't twig that John Smith was Thomas Gilmore. Look, we had a bad break. There's nothing I could do about it.
Bad, you say?
Maybe the cops don't know you're alive.
They know. You think the losers that have seen this aren't going to cash in on it? They know. And that whore and her pimp have photographs to prove it. Get him.
When we make the next drop, we'll grab him.
Now, I want him now. Who the hell is this Peter Hargraves, anyway?
I guess he's the go-between for Lisa Mullins and the pimp marshal.
Pick him up.
We must keep her away from dogs. She always breaks out if she touches them.
No, she's grown out of that, Lorelei.
Has she?
Well, I'm glad. Because we love dogs, don't we, darling?
We were going to get her a dog, actually.
Just a little one, though. I wouldn't want to see any accidents.
I'll get it.
That'll be Miss Ferguson.
Come on, darling.
Good afternoon. Yeah, I'd like to see Miss Lorelei Wilkinson. Is she in there? Mm. Get her coming.
Miss Wilkinson?
Yes?
Lorelei Wilkinson, you're under arrest for attempted armed robbery. I have to caution you that anything you say can be taken down and used against you in a court of law. Let's go.
No, but I can't. Well, not just now. You see, I've been in touch with John Ferguson from Wentworth.
Sorry.
No, but you see, I phoned her and she knows
that... And she telephoned us.
John sent you?
Come quietly, it's better that way.
But I don't understand. I mean, she promised. She promised, but I thought she'd come.
She said she may not be able to get away.
She shouldn't have done that. I was going to give myself up.
She explained all that. Come on.
I'll take her, Lorelei. You won't let her forget me, will you?
No.
Your mother.
But she won't know. She'll grow older not knowing and she'll think that you're her mother.
Ivan and I have discussed it. We've decided to be her aunt and uncle.
And we'll love her and we'll care for her. But she'll always know that you're her mother. And that you love her too.
Thank you.
Zoe. Look. Here we are, little princess. Goodbye, darling. Goodbye.
Worked him over pretty rough, too.
Then keep at it.
It's no good, he's out cold.
Then bring him round. Listen, Mal, I am starting to lose confidence in you. I want information about that pimp marshal. Now go and get it for me.
Hargraves isn't holding out, Mr. Gilmore. He doesn't know where Marshall is.
Then how is he going to get this letter to him?
Marshall plays it safe. He's the one that makes contact. Hargraves doesn't expect to hear from him till tomorrow or later.
I want Marshall now. He has to learn that nobody puts the screws on me. We've got to get to that girl, too.
That'll take time. She's inside.
Then we go inside. Tonight.
So, according to Lisa, she got the letter. I'm just praying it wasn't intercepted. Did you hear of any of the officers nabbing anyone?
No, not a thing. Well, go on.
Hopefully, when Lester Marshall learns he's dealing with Gilmore, he'll play ball with the police. When the police pick up Gilmore, it's the end of the assignment, and I'll be out of your hair.
Well, that'll be a relief all round if anyone suspects... Well, do it again, Glover, and this time I want it clean.
Yeah. Spider, listen, Lisa told me about the letter. How'd you go?
Well, what's it to you?
Well, I just want to make sure it's all right, you know. She's counting on you. Did you get it through?
Yeah. I got it through.
Her name is Lisa. Lisa Mullins. She's being held in H Block.
H Block Wentworth?
That's right. Do you know the place?
No, but I'll find it.
Damn it, you know how big that place is.
Stop worrying, Mal. She'll take care of it.
Well, it's not going to be like walking into a dress shop, is it?
Where did you find him?
Go on, Mel. Tell her.
I had a car racket going.
Pedal cars?
Come off it. I was clearing 200 grand a year.
Gosh.
What makes you the big expert, eh?
I don't discuss my work. I leave that to the amateurs. Please, continue, Mr. Gilmore.
I want to get to her boyfriend.
Who is?
Lester Marshall. You just have to find out from her where he is. But I want the information tonight.
And after I have extracted the information, she's dead?
Yes.
Horses, trots, or dogs?
Oh.
Well, do you want to place a bet or not?
Sure, but I'm a bit low on funds right now.
Place a low bet.
Anything to get the business out of a hole, eh, Maxwell? Does she have to pay protection or just split her buyer?
Nah, she don't do that no more, do you, Max?
There's a $5 limit. Are you interested?
All right.
Well, what do you like?
I don't know. What do you think?
Look, I just take the bets. You're the one who picks the winners.
I don't even know what's running.
All the girls in maternity bet on baby blue.
Kat, can I have a bet? What do you have to do
no,
to...
No, Merle, no bets. Okay, baby blue it is.
Right, have the money here in half an hour or the bet's off.
Okay.
Okay, get your orders in. Chop, sig, pooch, name it.
Well, I'll have some sigs.
How many?
A dozen, and some chocolate and some bourbon.
You can afford this, can you?
You got the stock?
I can get it. Little lay-by-plan?
Cash.
I'll have some booze.
Well, name it.
Bourbon. And brandy, and some gin too, and some vodka.
What is this?
Well, she's just trying to beat inflation. Oh, well, forget the vodka. I'll have lollies instead.
Oh, yeah, and me too. Hey, you got any sherbets?
No. This little trade's making quite a turnover. Enough to tempt a girl to get herself into retail.
Oh, Ed, you're in it already. Only you don't have to worry about stocktaking.
Well, how'd you like that? If she ever decides to sell that business, she won't get much on the goodwill.
Or the stock.
What do you think you're doing?
Keep it down.
Dragon spider.
Who isn't?
Why? Because I reckon she has got sherbet bombs and she's not there.
She's not. Will you back off?
No.
What?
Go on.
Look, if she's got sherbet bombs, we'll get him out of her. Now move.
Go on.
You better.
What are you two doing?
Well, we're on skip.
Well, where is it?
Oh, yeah, we forgot something.
Oh, well, come along.
She got the letter out.
Sure she did. She moved stuff in and out of here like it was a dispatch department.
Yeah, well, you can't just take it for granted. It's best to know for sure.
You can take it for granted that I'll be stepping out of here in a few days.
Guess so.
Hey, Wynn, you still broke?
Who isn't? Why?
I need $10 urgent.
Don't worry, I'll get it to you.
Made a bet with Maxwell and I want to pay up fast.
Has she made a move?
No, and I'm not giving her a chance to.
So I want to settle up.
Glover, cleaning duties do not include the laundry. What are you doing here?
Just leg.
Where's Merle?
Here a minute ago.
I think I'll start a movement to bring back the ball and chain.
Well, where do we go from here?
Downhill if we don't get that gun.
Oh, it's the ball. He's very possessive of it. Come, Charlie.
Jones, what are you doing here? Mrs. Morris wants to... Hey, wait a second. What have you got there?
Buzz off, or I'll shoot. You're a talk from the underworld. Hey, Mr. Adams. I was only kidding. Look, it's not even loaded. Hey, Mr. Adams. Want a lolly?
Okay, big spender, $15 all up.
I haven't got it.
Oh, you surprise me. And how about you?
Oh, I'm trying to give him up.
What a couple of amateurs.
Hold on to that brandy. I want it.
Cash.
Okay, okay.
Guess what I got?
B.O., take a walk, you big ox.
Don't you call me that or I'll kill you. You're the energy vampire come to take my powers away from me.
Gee, she's got it.
Okay, okay, Mel, hand it over.
Nah, it's mine.
Anxiety's superloon
was sent to me from the planet Krypton.
Did the screw see it?
Mr. Adams has seen it.
He's a dog from the underworld. Let's go! We're taking the caves of the dogs!
She's got to off like a
cat! We're after her!
Oh, my God, Mel!
Thanks, I really appreciate it. Pay back soon as the mayor comes in. Just keep out of Maxwell.
Hogs for the underworld! Hogs for the underworld!
I don't believe it! It's Merle!
You all right?
I don't know. She's gonna get me. I've gotta get out of here. I've gotta get away.
She's shit. There's something wrong with this.
Be careful!
She couldn't have been on the level.
I've gotta get out of here. I'm in worse shape than I thought.
Oh, gotcha! Jones!
Don't shoot! Don't! It's a fake.
What? It was just a game?
She's right, it can't be fired.
You seem to know a lot about this weapon, Maxwell. I want to see you and Jones in my office now.
It's all right. It's okay. Come on.
It's not Kaz's fault. And I didn't hurt anyone.
You threatened Mr. Adams.
No, I was just having a game with him and he ran away. I tried to tell him it wasn't real.
You terrorised him and several prisoners.
And threw the block into chaos.
I wouldn't do that. It was just fun.
Where did it come from? The gun mill. Where did it come from?
Not telling.
Jones.
It's all right.
No.
It's all right. Tell them.
Boiler room.
That's off limits.
I know, but I was following someone.
Who?
Who she was following is irrelevant. You know where the gun came from and you know it's harmless.
And how do you know that, Maxwell?
It's been around.
Is it yours?
No. Someone tried to sell it to me. I turned it down.
Why?
Because in here you need the real thing.
Who tried to sell it to you?
I can't remember.
Miss Ferguson?
Yes, Governor.
Return Maxwell to her duties. And have Mr. Adams meet me and Jones in the boiler room in 5 minutes.
Come on.
Have the locks changed, Mr. Adams.
What's over here? Come on, I'll show you. Lots of stuff in. It's all gone.
Are you sure this is where the contraband was hidden?
What?
The stuff you found, was it in here?
Yeah.
You sure you didn't clear it out?
No, I took some things, but there's lots of things left.
Aside from the gun, what else was there?
There was drinks and lollies and chocolates and tricks and there wasn't any sherbet bombs.
I want my stuff back you nicked.
I haven't got it.
Where is it?
I don't know. When I got back to my dorm, it had gone.
Dear Maxwell, you sure fooled us with that fake gun.
Yeah, things are going to be different now, right, Rita?
Right. Anything?
No, nothing.
You've got a lot to learn, Adams.
All right, Fisher, Murray, Young, you're on a charge for concealed contraband. Get to your cells.
I'm not going to forget this.
Nor am I. Sorry I scared you.
Yeah.
It's all right.
Oh, no. Oh, bloody hell. What are you doing here? Did you forget something?
It's a long story.
You're in with Connors and Jenkins.
At least that's something.
Oh.
Different than on the inside, the sun still shines.